friends, welcome to my channel, Animated Study.
Do you think your word program directly interact with your hard disk? Do you think your mobile apps will directly use the processor to run? The answer is no. You require mediator software that works on system level. Or we can say it will interact with the hardware that is called operating system or OS. Operating system is also called resource manager, which manages all the resources, that is hardware, including CPU, RAM, disk, network, and input-output devices. Popular operating systems are Windows, Linux, Android, and Macintosh. When the computer is turned on, it first performs the power on self test, and if no issues are found, the bootstrap loader will load the operating system for the computer into memory. Now user can start interact with the computer via applications and program. This application program internally use operating system. Operating system core part, which is called kernel, interact with the hardware like CPU, memory, and all kind of input-output devices. The objective of an operating system is to provide an interface to the user through which the user can interact with the computer. There are many types of user interfaces. Let's see one by one. Command-based interface. Command-based interface requires a user to enter the command to perform different tasks like creating, opening, editing, or deleting a file. Example of operating systems which command-based interface include MS-DOS and Unix. Graphical user interface. Graphical user interface, also known as GUI, lets user run program or interact with computers in the form of icons, menu, and other visual options. Example of GUI based OS are Microsoft Windows, Ubuntu, Fedora, and Macintosh. Touch-based interface. Today, smartphones, tablets, and PCs allow user to interact with the system simply using the finger touch. Example of popular operating systems with touch-based interfaces are Android and iOS. Modern Windows operating system is also support touch-based interfaces on touchscreen devices. Voice-based interface. User today can use voice-based commands to make a computer work in the desired way and give the input without keyboard or mouse or touchscreen. Some operating system which provide voice-based control to user include iOS Siri, Android OK Google are few example of voice-based interface. Gesture-based interface. Some smartphones based on Android and iOS as well as laptops let user interact with the device using gesture like waving, tilting, and eye motion. Now we will see important functions of operating system. Process management. In computer, different processes are running simultaneously. It is the responsibility of operating system to manage these processes and get multiple tasks completed in minimum time. As CPU is the main resource of the computer system, it's allocated among processes in efficient way is managed by the operating system. Memory management. Primary or main memory of a computer system is usually limited. The main task of memory management is to allocate and free memory from running processes. This is done for every processes dynamically by operating system without affecting other processes. File management. Data and programs are stored permanently as file in the secondary storage, commonly hard disk, SSD, pen drive, CD or DVD, and magnetic tape in computer. Operating systems takes care of creation, protection against illegal user, updation, and deletion of all these files in the secondary memory. Device management. A computer system has many I/O devices and hardware connected to it. Operating system manages these different types of devices that are interdependent. The operating system interacts with the device driver and related software for particular devices. That's all for operating system. If you like this video, please like and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to click the bell icon to get new video updates. Thank you for watching.